open to see. Open to be free, open to be. Open to the light of the love that shines. Mm-hmm. Open to accept, open to I don't mind. Mm-hmm. Open to myself. Open to change, into the changeless, open, oh, open.
Receive your first kiss. It feels as if I've never danced before, as if I've never even sung before, as if I've never walked the streets of this world, as if I died and was reborn yesterday, as if I died and was reborn yesterday, as if, since I met your loving eyes, it feels as if I've never seen the sunshine, as if I've never felt the wind caress my skin, as if I've never been alive before, as if I died and was reborn yesterday, as if I died and was reborn yesterday. easy, as easy, as easy, as doesn't come from my peace of being. I know no music that doesn't rise from the silence within. As if, as if, as if. As if, as if I died and was reborn yesterday. As if I died and was reborn yesterday. Now that I've been kissed from within. Now that I've been kissed from within. Now that I've been kissed from within.
Kissed from within.
Now that I've been kissed from revealed. The is revealed. Om Trayambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam Orvarukamiva Bandhanam Pratyormukshiyam Amritam Om Trayambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam Orvarukamiva Bandhanam Pratyormukshiyam Amritam I am your absence and you are my presence. You are my absence and I am your presence. And where these two meet, a vanishing happens. The Atman is revealed. The Atman is revealed. I am your absence, and you I am your presence, and where these two meet, a vanishing happens. The Atman is revealed. The is revealed. The Atman is revealed.
Thank you, my dear. Namaste, namaste, everyone. Very warm welcome to Satsang today. Sadhguru Shri Moji Ji Ki Jai. Welcome, welcome, welcome. In the hangout, the way to ask questions is to unmute your mics. On YouTube chat, you can post your question over there and we will look at them. There are times in everyone's life, this experience called life, that everything seems completely hopeless. Everything seems completely hopeless and it looks like we are closed in, we are boxed in from all directions. And it seems like the most miserable time that anyone can have. It seems like this, isn't it, that when you run out of moves, You don't know what to do. No one is accepting you. You know, all these kind of things are happening. Whatever they might be related to, usually around relationships, but also sometimes around other topics. And it must be seen that when I run out of moves like this outside, and also I run out of moves inside, because what do we first try and do? How can I figure out the right solution? How do I figure this out? First we try to rationalize, or first we try to say, okay, if I do this, then can I fix it? Doesn't work. If I do this, can I fix it? Doesn't work. Then we try to rationalize it to ourselves. We also try to rationalize it to ourselves and say something to make us feel better. But we see that no thought is helping. No idea, no concept is helping. And it can seem like this is a terrible place to be. No action is helping, no thought is helping. All my emotions, sensations, all of them seem negative. Then what are we left with? You see? No action, no thought, no emotion. Nothing is helping. What is left? And that is why actually, although to the mind all of this sounded very terrible, it is the most auspicious thing to happen. Because we left our reliance on action, we left our reliance on thoughts, and we left our reliance on emotion or how we are feeling. And this leads to opening of a door which is opening inside. To this discovery, to finding out what is here prior to emotion, what is here prior to thought, what is here prior to outside action. And usually in the world it is seen that unless these kind of strong situations come, we are not truly open to looking. Usually, in some cases it happens on its own, or the urge to self-discovery is present without any of these events. But usually, in most cases, it is found that you need this to be boxed in. And to run out of moves, like my master says. Nothing, no practice also is helping. No mantra is helping, no practice is helping, nothing is changing. Emotions are still negative, thoughts are attacking and defensive. And outward action is seeming like more and more conflict only is coming. Then what is left? This is the wonderful opportunity to discover that which is beyond all of this appearance. All of these appearances will come and go. That which remains, this is the opportunity to discover that. It's very beautiful, because now we are not going to be satisfied just by some answer, some concept. Because we are saying, I'm done with it all. All spirituality, I've studied books, I read the great masters and sages, and yet I am here. I have done all the japa, all the pradakshina, all the kriya, everything which is prescribed, and yet I am here. It's a beautiful opening. It's a beautiful opening. I know it's not easy to accept when we are going through this, but you will discover that you're getting gifts greater than any other gift. You're gifting yourself back to yourself. You're losing all interest in that which is mental, that which is external. This is the beautiful dispassion of Ram. If some of you have read the Yoga Vasishtha, you see that initially Ram is completely despondent, although he has everything. He's a prince. But he's so despondent. You see? And if you read only that chapter in the Yoga Vasishtha, you could end up being completely depressed, actually. Because the futility of this world seems so clear when the young prince says, "What is in all of this? All these jewels in this palace, and all these pleasures and things. When I was a baby, I cried. As a teenager, I'm driven by all these needs and desires. When I'm older, then I want more and more conquest. When I get older, I'm worried about this body is going. What is the point of all of this?" What happened in this dispassion? Because he was not interested. His father says, "The whole kingdom is here for you. All of your people, they're waiting for you expectantly. You will be a great king." And he says, "I'm just not interested. None of this interests me. I don't find anything which is lasting. I don't find anything which is meaningful. Tell me, father, what is it? What is all of this about?" And although it sounds like the story of a young prince long, many, many years ago, isn't it our story really? We go from these phases and phases through life, being somebody, wanting some things. And what happened? Did we find that lasting peace? Did we find that joy? Did we find meaning in anything in the world? So then the question to be asked is, when this strong feeling of dispassion comes, almost to the level of despondency, then is it good news or bad news? Because what happens after that? After that, what happens is the great sage Vasishtha comes and he just shares the truths. He shares the truths. And what happened? Did the entire set of people, the council of ministers and the king and everyone who was listening to what Vasishtha had to say, did they all discover the truth for themselves? No, it was just Ram. It was made ripe enough through all of this seeming suffering. So almost once a week, actually, someone will come and they say that I'm just stuck. I don't know what to do, where to go, what is going to happen. Sometimes I will say that even this is grace. And sometimes it feels inappropriate to say that because the situation can seem so strong on the outside. But inwardly, I know this is still grace. And it's a beautiful time. It's a beautiful time to be stuck in this way. Because we want to now not pretend about anything. No thought is attractive to us. Even emotions we don't care about. Because we've seen that they come and go. So already most of the work of satsang is done. If you're here already. So not even words, not even pointing is required. Just to be in the presence, satsang will open out. The only caution is not to go with any fantasy, any visualization, any ideas. Only just report from whatever is clearly perceived. You make no visuals about anything at all. If God is here, he must come and get me now. Because I am done. You see, like this it becomes. So you make this call to God. If you're here, just come now. I'm done with all my strategy, plans, ideas about life. All my identities, all have gone to dust. I am empty now of all of this. And then the master appears and he says, yes, God is here. Find out what is here. Does that which is here have a desire, have some aversions? Have some ideas about life. No, that comes later. That comes later. And we are not to give importance to the trickster which comes and says all kinds of things. Be clear that it is a trickster. Be completely clear that the mind is only a trickster. Even the great sage Kabir in India has said that this mind is a thug. Roughly translated from, I know the word thug has become part of the English dictionary also, but roughly translated from Hindi, it means con, it's a con artist. So now as you're discovering what is here already, don't go with any mental commentary about which is trying to interpret your discovery, which is trying to comment on what is being discovered or not. Just stay with what is. Let everything else come and go. Stay with what is not coming and going. Then you will see that even the instruction stay with is not required because you are that already. This body will come and go. One of my teachers said, we live as if we will never die, and we die as if we never lived. To know that this body will come and go. All our thoughts, attachments, identities, everything will be dust. All these emotions and sensations, nothing, they mean nothing. Don't spend another instant on giving meaning and belief to all this which is completely meaningless. The master says, when we chase the world, then the world runs from us. And when we stop, then the world wants to come and kiss us. Truly ask whether I am done with this play. And be completely honest with yourself at least about the answer. Because many times externally we can keep saying, yes, yes, I'm done. Internally we're still hoping for something to happen here which will be meaningful. You see, the story to have a nice turn or a nice ending. And if something still wants to play, then nothing can stop it. But at least then you will be clear that it is a play. Therefore, this contemplation is very important. I can only share from what has been seen here. And what has been seen here is that nothing that is changing, nothing that is coming and going, nothing that has states. As meaning for me now. Of course, the realm has still complete potential for joy and grief. But even these are just appearances, part of the play. And I remain untouched from all of this. I'm speaking as your voice now, your own inner voice. Because even through these seeming strong upheavals, you will not deny that there is a silent witnessing. Just quietly, just aware of all that is happening in front of it. So when I say that, oh, so much, all this is happening to me, there is still the witnessing of it, isn't it, to which nothing is happening. No matter what the happening is, how strong it might seem, then you find this witnessing, and then it is natural for us to ask, am I this content which is, am I just this happening which is happening, or am I the witnessing of it? And don't let your mind come in and be smart here, because then it will start applying Advaita very quickly and say, but I am both. Just look. Am I that which is changing, which is appearing and disappearing? Or am I that which is the unconcerned witnessing of this entire play? then you find that I am just this witnessing, untouched by any of this play. And then we can say that, yes, even this play is arising within me as me. Therefore, earlier I used to say that, first just be the witness. Just remain as the witness. Witness of thoughts, witness of sensations, witness of the world, witness of the body. Just remain as the witness. Then after some time I will ask you, is there even an entity called the witness? Aren't you just this witnessing itself? If there were some attributes to this entity, wouldn't those also be witnessed? And are you ever just the content of what is witnessed? Are you not primarily the witnessing itself, this awareness itself? Aren't you this space which is prior to phenomenal space? Are you touched by time? And if you're not touched by space and time, then how can events in space and time really touch you? How can that which is born inside this space-time touch you, if space and time itself are born inside you? See, if this is not your experience already, don't let these just be words. See that all that is arising is just a dance in front of you. Who is this I? Can we not now leave aside everything that happens in space and time to the creator of space and time? Should it not really be his problem? Can a mere object in space and time do anything to change this realm of time and space. Therefore, now get this burden off your shoulders, that you can move a blade of grass here. Rid yourself of this arrogance that any power you have. I cry with you and I laugh with you. But it is never forgotten that all of this is just God's Leela. I've really been speaking for a long time. Thank you. My master says very beautifully, he says, you've played according to your rules for a long time. Now will you agree to play by my rules? Every day is a mess. Thing is waiting for me. Also, the idea that I'm just this person, it could be I'm just this simple person, I'm this nice person. Any idea which ends with something person is still arrogance. Why is it arrogance? Because it implies that there is something here which had the power to separate itself from God and become a person. So the use of the word I conversationally is completely fine. But be aware of the word I. Beware of the word I when it is used seriously to call yourself other than this awareness or this being. Therefore, beware of this I, which is personal, and it is only the door to suffering. It's time for rest of sins. David said, glad to see they have strepsils in India, but it's strepsils Ayurvedic. Can you read it? Strepsils Ayurvedic. There has to be an India twist to everything. Atma, you want some?
Yeah. Yes, Father, please. Thank you. No, I prefer the chocolate. If I so well, it was a chocolate. Yeah. I'm a lover of chocolate. Thank you.
Yes.
Yeah, yes, yes. Father, may I share something? Just came now spontaneously to share. Yesterday I posted, maybe you have not seen that yet, but later maybe you can see, on the chat for retreat for Tiru, I've posted a long message explaining that I cannot come. And I explained why and everything. So yesterday, I got up at 5 a.m. and then came to me to research about this because I had two possibilities with the two passports. And I said, okay, or to go to Budapest because there is no Indian embassy here, just the for Bosnia to in Budapest, which is very far away from here. And the other is to go to Croatia, to Zagreb, because I have also Croatian citizen. So I explored everything, and really, you will see, I have written everything. So all day yesterday I was in that, totally, not even needed to watch everything what was going on, because it was not here, it was then I spoken with my mother and everything, but it was actually I was speaking, explaining. And so at the evening, at the end of the day, just it was like a process going on all the day. I was watching all possibilities, calling all embassies 2 times, 3 times, everything. I really did everything. Then calculated in my mind 100 times, and then suddenly in the evening, everything dropped, left, and I understood, yes, I will not go and it's impossible for this time, but it was without a little bit of sadness, nothing, just was the process of whole day going, and at the end it was, I said to my mother, but I have already been there, you know, all these days speaking with Sangha, with beloveds, having all emotions, leaving it inside, outside, and then the day of yesterday, whole day, I don't even know when it passed, because so many hours, like one moment. So I said, but I've been there, it's done, it's something felt inside, like this, and really, you said what you were speaking in the beginning, I don't remember, but it's everything is happening here. This being is project, creating everything, and it was like energy, like was going out with all this out, and everything was happening, and then everything coming back to me, and then dropped, And I felt, but I'm here. I have not even moved. Everything happened, created ideas, imagination, thoughts I was going, feelings, and then everything came back here and dissolved. So I feel very good. I feel perfect. I don't know how to say. I don't miss anything. I really don't. It's just, I'm here, you know. It's okay, just that. Thank you.
Very good, my dear. It's very good. It's sometimes there's just, it becomes clear. So for those of you just joining on YouTube, I was saying that I'm feeling upset enough now. So maybe we can have some singing and then we close at some early today. What do you want to say? If you're just joining on YouTube, I was saying that I'm feeling upset enough now. All the YouTube now. So maybe we can have some singing. I think we can, maybe we post the Hangout link in the description also. If some trolls come, it's okay, they'll just hear some singing models. Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Shivaya Namah. Shivaya Namah. Shivaya Namah. Om Namah Shivaya. 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 Shivaya Namah. Shivaya Namah. Shivaya Namah. Om Namah Shivaya. 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 Shivaya Namah. Shivaya Namah. Shivaya Namah. Om Namah Shivaya. 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 Shivaya Namah. Shivaya Namah. Shivaya Namah. Om Namah Shivaya. 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 Om Namah Shivaya.
Yeah, you want to sing something?
Yeah. Oh, were you asking me or Sangeeta?
You, my dear, first and then Sangeeta.
Oh, okay. I'll take my guitar. City, city, a call, city, a call, Mahakal, Mahakal, Satinam, a call, Mood to a Guru. Sat city, city, a call, city, a call, Mahakal, Mahakal, Satinam. Mukha Murtu Vahe Guru.
Sat city, city akal, city akal, mahakal, mahakal, satinam, akal murtuwa he guru. Sat city akal, mahakal, mahakal, satinam. Sat Siri Siri Akal Siri Akal Mahakal Mahakal Satinam Akal Murtu Wahi Guru. Sat Siri Siri Akal Siri Akal Mahakal Mahakal Satnam Akal Murtu Wahe Guru. Sat Siri Siri Akal Siri Akal Mahakal Mahakal Satnam Akal Murtu Wahe Guru. Sat Siri Siri Akal Siri Akal Mahakal Mahakal Satnam Akal Murtu Wahe Guru. Sat Siri Siri Akal Siri Akal Mahakal Mahakal Satnam Akal Murtu Wahe Guru. Sat Siri Siri Akal Siri Akal Mahakal Mahakal Satnam Akal Murtu Wahe Guru.
Thank you, my love. Thank you so much. Sangeeta, you want to sing something, my dear?
Namaste, Father. Namaste, all. Have you got any song? I mean, you want me to sing? There is nothing coming up in my mind at the moment.
My favorite one. You know my favorite one, which is
favorite.
Yeah. Tere kadmo ke nishan mein.
Okay. Yeah. I don't even remember the lyrics. I'll have to get my copy.
Okay. make it the reality.
तुम ही से ज्ञान का दीपक जला है, तुम ही से घनघोर अंधेरा मिटा है, तुम जो नहीं गुरु जी कुछ भी नहीं है, हमें रास्तों की जरूरत नहीं है, हमें तेरे पैरों के निशान मिल गए, हमें रास्तों की जरूरत नहीं है, हमें तेरे पैरों के निशान मिल गए हैं। तुम ही हो शिव और ब्रह्म का संगम, सब कुछ तुम्हारा, सब तुम पे अर्पण, अब तेरा मैं हूँ, मुझ में ही तू है, हमें रास्तों की जरूरत नहीं है, हमें तेरे पैरों के निशान मिल गए हैं। फूलों में तू है, कलियों में तू है, सागर एक एक लहर में भी तू है, कहीं भी मैं जाऊं बस तू ही तू है, हमें रास्तों की जरूरत नहीं है, हमें तेरे पैरों के निशान मिल गए हैं, हमें रास्तों की जरूरत नहीं है, हमें तेरे पैरों के निशान मिल गए हैं। छाए जो दिल पे गम का अंधेरा, तन्हाइयों ने जो मन को घेरा, खिलता सवेरा लेकर तू रूबरू है, हमें रास्तों की जरूरत नहीं है, हमें तेरे पैरों के निशान मिल गए हैं। हमें रास्तों की जरूरत नहीं है, हमें तेरे पैरों के निशान मिल गए हैं। जन जन की सेवा यही मेरी पूजा, तुम ही तुम हो, कोई न दूजा, तुमसे है सब कुछ रोशन, कण कण में तू है, हमें रास्तों की जरूरत नहीं है, हमें तेरे पैरों के निशान मिल गए, हमें रास्तों की जरूरत नहीं है, हमें तेरे पैरों के निशान मिल गए, हमें रातों की जरूरत नहीं है, हमें तेरे पैरों के निशान मिल गए
Very good, very good. Very good. Very beautiful. Yes, of course.
निरन कर ले मेरे मना, तेरी बीती जाती उम्र हरे नाम बिना, हरे नाम बिना। सुमिरन कर ले मेरे मना, कूप नीर बिन धैन क्षीर बिन धरती मेघ बिना, धरती मेघ बिना। जैसे तरुवर फल बिन हीना, तैसे प्राणी हरे नाम बिना, हरे नाम बिना। सुमिरन कर ले मेरे मना, काम क्रोध मद लोभ निहारो, काम क्रोध मद लोभ निहारो, छाड़ दे अब संत जना, छाड़ दे अब संत जना। कह नानक सार सुन भगवंता, कह नानक सार सुन भगवंता, या जग में नहीं कोई अपना, तुम्ही रन कर है मेरे मना तेरी बीती जाती उम्र हरे नाम बिना हरे नाम बिना हरे नाम बिना सुमिरन कर ले मेरे मना नमो 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 रमण सदाशिव प्रभावर्ण नमो महर्षि नमो महर्षि नमो 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 रमण सदाशिव प्रभावर्ण नमो महर्षि नमो महर्षि दर्शन सुख मंगलम सकल जीव सम्मुख ब्रह्म संधिरे दर्शन सुख मंगल मुख सकल जीव हित सम्मुख ब्रह्म संधिरे नमो 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 रमण सदाशिव प्रभावर्ण नमो महर्षि नमो महर्षि ನಮ್ಮ ಮನವದೊಂದು ಕಾಡು ನೀನರಿತಿಹೆ ಅದರ ಜಾಡು ನಮ್ಮ ಮನವದೊಂದು ಕಾಡು ನೀನರಿತಿಹೆ ಅದರ ಜಾಡು ಹಿತವನರಿತು ನೀಡು ತೆಮ್ಮ ಕೊರೆಯ ತಣಿಸಲೈ ಹಿತವನರಿತು ನೀಡು ತೆಮ್ಮ ಕೊರೆಯ ತಣಿಸಲೈ ನಮೋ 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 ರಮಣ ಸದಾಶಿವ ಪ್ರಭಾವರ್ಣ ನಮೋ ಮಹರ್ಷಿ ನಮೋ ಮಹರ್ಷಿ ಬೇಡಲೆಂದು ಬಂದ ನಾವು ನೋಡಿಯೇ ತಣಿವೆ ವೈಯ ಬೇಡಲೆಂದು ಬಂದ ನಾವು ನೋಡಿಯೇ ತಣಿವೆ ವೈಯ ಮೋಡಿಗಾರನೇಯೇ ಮೋಡಿಗಾರನೇಯೇ ಹಿತವ ನುಡಿದು ಪೊರೆ ನಮ್ಮನು ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಸಂಗಿಯೇ ಹಿತವ ನುಡಿದು ಪೊರೆ ನಮ್ಮನು ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಸಂಗಿಯೇ ನಮೋ 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 ರಮಣ ಸದಾಶಿವ ಪ್ರಭಾವರ್ಣ ನಮೋ ಮಹರ್ಷಿ ಮಹರ್ಷಿ
Ha ha ha.
Very good, my dear. Very good. You know, this process of self-discovery is unfolding, and it's very good that sometimes all this pent-up conditioning, some pent-up thing like this, it just comes up in satsang and can be allowed to be completely released. It's very good.
I don't even have words to say what to say. Thank you so much, Father.
No, thank you, Nanda. What do you have? I'm always with you. I'm always right there with you. And you're always right here. We can play the invocations now. Jess, you have them.
Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwara, Gurur Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Dhyanamulam Gurur Murti, Pujamulam Gurur Padam, Mantramulam Gurur Vakyam, Mokshamulam Gurur Kripa, Mokshamulam Mujiji Kripa, Mokshamulam Anandaji Kripa. Sarvesham Swastir Bhavatu, Sarvesham Shantir Bhavatu, Sarvesham Purnam Bhavatu, Sarvesham Mangalam Bhavatu, Sarve Bhavantu Sakina, Sarve Santu Niramya, Sarve Patrani Pashantu, Makaschit Dukabak Bhavit, Asato masat kamiya, tamaso ma jyotir gamiya, mrityur ma amritam gamiya. Om purnamidam, purnamidam, purnat purnamadachate, purnasya purnamadaya, purnameva vashishate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Brahma Paramastu. Om Shri Satguru Bhagavan Ki Jai. Om Shri Satguru Mujiji Ki Jai.
Thank you also very much for being in satsang today. Sadhguru Shri Mujiji ki jai.
Sadhguru Shri Mujiji ki
jai.
Jai.
Jai. Jai.
Jai.
Thank you, thank you.
Love you all, love you all.
Okay, my love, thank you so much. We can end the podcast now.